children, yesterday I have given note on the topic colligative property. Colligative properties, those properties of dilute solution which are directly proportional to number of solute particles. Property of solution which are directly proportional to number of solute particles are called colligative property. And these properties are lowering in vapor pressure, osmotic pressure, elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point. Okay, so out of these four properties, we will discuss one by one each topic in this chapter. The first topic is lowering in vapor pressure. This is a very important topic. Lowering in vapor pressure. So before that, we have to understand what is lowering in what is vapor pressure. Okay, this diagram is very important. You can say backbone of this chapter. So see properly. In a container, we have taken solvent molecule. These are the solvent molecule which are liquid in the state. Let vapor pressure is 50 centimeter Hg. This is vapor pressure of solvent. You can say P. Vapor pressure of solvent, that is P, is equal to 50. Let atmospheric pressure is 1 atm. 1 atm equal to 76 centimeter Hg. As you know, temperature is directly proportional to vapor pressure. So when you start heating, vapor pressure also increases. By rising temperature, so vapor pressure increases. When vapor pressure increases, it becomes 50, then 60, 70, 75, 76. Then that is the boiling point. The temperature is boiling point of that liquid. At that temperature, solvent molecule leave their surface and become upside in free state, and upper molecule become lower to surface, take heat and again goes to upper surface, that is free. So this is formation of vapors. Solvent to vapor, this process is known as vaporization. Okay, if container is closed, then after some time this vapor again change into liquid. This process in which vapor change into liquid solvent called condensation. At the equilibrium in both vaporization and condensation, the pressure exerted by vapors in against vaporization is called vapor pressure. It's called vapor pressure. The 50 is the vapor pressure of solvent. Again, understand the topic. What is vapor pressure? The pressure exerted by vapors in against vaporization at the equilibrium in between vaporization and condensation is called vapor pressure. Now, when you add solute into the liquid, but solute, the nature of solute should be two type, non-volatile and non-electrolyte. What is non-volatile? Substance which can change into liquid after heating, that is volatile. So solute should be non-volatile. It means this should not change into liquid, like sugar, salt. Okay, water is volatile because water after heating change into gas. What is non-electrolyte? Electrolyte substance which can ionize into their ions, though it should non-electrolyte, like sugar, like not NaCl. NaCl is electrolyte. Sugar is non-electrolyte because sugar will not ionize in their aqueous solution. Okay, when you put solute into the liquid, it occupies the space, intermolecular space. In that condition, solvent cannot move freely. As a result, less vapors are formed. When less vapors are formed, then automatically vapor pressure decreases. Let PS is vapor pressure of solution. Vapor pressure of solution. Why solution? Because you put solute into solvent, now it becomes solution. PS is always less than P, that is 40 centimeter Hg. Let. Then lowering in vapor pressure P, lowering in vapor pressure P minus PS, this equal to 50 minus 40 equal to 10. Now, we are going to explain why lowering in vapor pressure is a colligative property. When you put again solute, it occupies more space and it creates more hindrance in the path of solvent which are going for the vaporization. So again very less vapors are formed. Automatically vapor pressure again decreases. Let now PS is become 30 centimeter Hg. Then delta P, again P minus PS, the P is remain same, but PS is 30, the lowering is now 20. The vapor, when you add solute into solvent, vapor pressure decreases, but lowering increases. You can see 10, then 20. If you again put the solute, vapor pressure again decreases, let 20, then 50 minus 20, 30. So this is lowering in vapor pressure, which is a colligative property. Okay, note I have given. Whole process I think you can understand. After this we will go for the topic, Raoult's law for lowering in vapor pressure. Okay, thank you.